Friends, welcome to my channel. Now I am in the previous video I have given you the friction in bearings. I have done it. I have given you all the formulae that are required to do the problems. Now I will do a couple of problems and then move on. So I have selected some problems from your question bank. I have selected the fifth problem in the question bank. A conical pivot supports a load of 20 kN. So W is 20 kN, right? Cone angle is 120 degree, that is 2 alpha is 120 degree or alpha is 60 degrees. Alpha 60 degree, and the intensity of normal pressure, that is PB, is not to exceed 0.3 Newton per mm square. The external diameter is twice the internal diameter. Calculate the outer and inner diameter. Find out what is capital D and what is small d of the bearing surface. If the shaft rotates at 200 rpm, capital N is 200 rpm, and the coefficient of friction is mu is 0.1. Calculate the power lost in friction. Assume uniform pressure. What is the power lost? He says assume uniform pressure. Generally, it will be uniform pressure. Now, when he says external and internal diameter, there are two diameters. That means it is a truncated conical pivot bearing. It's a truncated conical pivot bearing. Now, the formula, assuming uniform pressure, the formula is for T is equal to 2/3 mu w by sin alpha into r cube divided by r square. To get P, I have to get this T. To get this T, I have mu, I have W, I have alpha, but I don't know R and R. So first, I have to find out R and R. So W, the formula for W is PB into pi into R square minus R square. This is the formula. So here, this is given in Newton per mm square. I will convert it into kilonewton per square meter. It will be 300 kilonewton per square meter. Why? Because to convert it from Newton to kilonewton, I have to divide it by 1000. From mm square to meter square, I have to multiply it by 1000 into 1000. So 1000 will get cancelled. So 0.3 into 1000, that will be 300 kilonewton per cubic meter. Now this is a square meter. W is 20, PB is 300 into pi into R. If D is 2D, then capital R will be also equal to 2R. So here it will be 2R the whole square minus R square. R square means capital R square means it is capital R into capital R. So this is 2R into 2R. So it should be 2R the whole square. If you leave this bracket, you are going to commit a mistake. So 20 is equal to 300 into pi into 4R square minus R square, that is 3R square. So R square will be equal to 20 divided by 300 into pi into this 3 here. 4R square minus R square means it is 1R square. 4R square minus R square is 3. So this one will give you r square. R will be the square root of that. R will be root of that. So let us see what we get here. So 20 divided by 300 divided by pi divided by 3 equals 7.07 into 10 to the power of minus 3. Square root of answer will give me 0.084 meters. This is small r. Now capital R is 2 times small r. So 2 into 0.084, that is 0.168 meters, or 168 mm. This is 84 mm, right? So I got now capital R and small r. Now if I substitute these values here in this equation, I get the torque lost due to friction. So this will be 2 by 3 mu is 0.1 into W is 20 divided by sine of 60 degree into R cube, 0.168 cube minus 0.084 cube divided by 0.168 square minus 0.084 square. This will give me in kilonewton meters. Let us see how to do it. First, we will do this. We will do that bracket. Open a bracket. 0.168 cube to the power of 3 minus 0.084 to the power of 3. Close the bracket. Divided by, open another bracket, 0.168 square minus 0.084 square, close the bracket, equals, now press. So this works out to 0.196 multiplied by 20 multiplied by 0.1 multiplied by 2 divided by 3 divided by sine of 60 degrees. This whole thing will be 0.3. Approximately it will be 0.3 kilonewton meter. 0.3 something is there. 0.30176. You can take it as 0.3 kilonewton meter. So I got T now. After that, so this will be, this small d will be, small d will be 0.168 meters. This will be double of that. That is 0.336 meters, 336 mm, 168 mm. And now I have to find out P, power lost due to friction. Power lost due to friction will be equal to, P is equal to 2 pi nt by 60, n is given as 200, so 2 pi into 200 into 0.3 divided by 60, so many kilowatts. So that will be 2 into pi into 200 into 0.3 divided by 60, that is 6.28 kilowatts. 6.28 kilowatts. So we have found out the power lost in friction at this bearing. So this is first problem I have taken here. Next, I have selected the sixth problem, which is again of similar type. A conical pivot, sixth problem. A conical pivot bearing supports a vertical shaft of 200 mm diameter. So capital D is 200 mm, right? 200 mm diameter. It is subjected to a load of 30 kilonewtons. So W is 30 kilonewton. The cone angle is 120 degree. That is 2 alpha is 120 degree or alpha is 60 degree. And the coefficient of friction is 0.025. Calculate the power lost in friction. Calculate the power lost in friction when the speed is 140 rpm, assuming uniform pressure. Now, this is a simpler problem than that. Here, there is only one diameter, so it is full pivot, conical pivot. There are no two diameters there. So it is not a truncated this thing. The formula for assuming uniform pressure, T will be equal to 2 by 3 mu WR divided by sin alpha. That's all. So 2 into mu 0.025 into W 30 into R is, this is 0.2 meter, so it will be 0.1 meter divided by 3 into sine of 60 degrees. That's it. So many kilonewton meters. So 2 into 0.025 into 30 into 0.1 divided by 3 divided by sine 60. That will give me 0.0577 kilonewton meter. This is in kilonewton, this is in meter. So I get it in kilonewton meter. P is 2 pi nt by 60. That is 2 into pi into n is 140 into t is 0.0577 divided by 60. So 2 into pi into 140 into 0.0577 divided by 60. That gives me 0.846 roughly. So many kilowatts. This is the power lost due to friction. A simple problem. Let us do one more problem. That is, it goes like this. This is the eighth problem selected from the question bank. Problem number 8. A shaft has a number of collars integral with it. So it's a multi-collar bearing. The external diameter of the collar is 400 mm. 400 mm is the external dia, and the shaft diameter, that means small d, is 250 mm. It is, if the intensity of pressure is 0.35 newton per mm square uniform, that is PB is 0.35 newton per mm square, and you have to assume that it is uniform throughout the surface, that is assume uniform pressure, and the coefficient of friction is 0.05, mu is 0.05. Calculate power absorbed in friction when the shaft runs at 105 rpm carrying a load of 150 kilonewton. Also calculate the number of collars. So two things, one is power and the other one is number of collars are to be found out. So this problem is on multi-flat collar bearing. So first, what you do, So capital R will be half of this, that is 200 mm, or it is 0.2 meter. Small r will be half of this, that is 125 mm, or it is 0.125 meters. Convert them. Now convert this into kilonewton per square meter. It will be multiplied by 1000, that is 350 kilonewton per square meter. Other things, no necessity to convert anything, it's all there. Now assuming uniform pressure, assuming uniform pressure, you know this is Pb into pi into r square minus r square into n. So n will be equal to W divided by Pb into pi into r square minus r square. So substitute now, W is 150 divided by Pb is 350 into pi into r square, 0.2 square minus 0.125 square. This is the substitution. Now the answer calculate. First what you do this 0.2 square minus 0.125 square equals 0.024 something you got into pi into pi into 350. This will give me 26.8. Keep that as it is, type 150 divided by answer, divided by answer will give me 5.59. N is equal to 5.59. You cannot have fractional number of colors. Say N is equal to number of colors is 6. We have to have 6 colors. This is first part. This N is got. Next, you have to find out power. To find power, the formula is 2 pi NT. Now, to get power, we have to first find out T. T is 2 by 3 mu W into R cube minus R cube divided by R square minus R square. This is the formula for T. So we know everything here. 2 by 3 into, this is 0.05, mu is 0.05, W is 150 multiplied by 0.2 cube minus 0.125 cube divided by 0.2 square minus 0.125 square. This will give me torque, T, last in friction. So, open a bracket, 0.2 to the power of 3 minus 0.125 to the power of 3, close the bracket, divided by, open a bracket, 0.2 square minus 0.125 square, close the bracket, equals. So this will be 0.248 into 150 into 0.05 into 2 divided by 3. I got it as 1.24 kilonewton meter. Next, P is 2 pi NT by 60, that is 2 pi into N is 105 into T is 1.24 divided by 60. So this into 105 into pi into 2 divided by 60. It will give me 13.6 kilowatts. 13.6 kilowatt, this is the power last due to friction. Power loss due to friction is that much. So we have done three problems. Now, if any other problem you have which cannot be solved, then you can send it to me. I will solve and give you.